God is inviting us to be not just informed by his scripture, but to be transformed by it. The authors of the book we've been going through say that scripture tells the truest story about reality. It tells the true story about creation and about you and about me. And that when we read scripture, we ought to be not just informed about who we are, but transformed into who God wants us to be. And so we actually declare that the scriptures tell the truest story about you and me. And if we want to see how that looks in practice, we can look just at the life of Jesus. Jesus knew that the scriptures told the truest story about who he was. Take, for example, his temptation in the wilderness right after he was baptized. John the Baptist took him down into the Jordan River and he was baptized, and the Spirit of God descended on him, showing the approval of God. And the voice of God spoke, "You are my beloved, in you I am well pleased." And not long after that, he was taken into the desert to be tempted by Satan. And Satan undermined the story of Scripture. He told Jesus that you have to do things to prove your identity, that you need to earn it and demonstrate it before me. And Jesus clung to the story of Scripture, that he was the beloved Son of God and was able to navigate through the temptations and trial that Satan threw his way. That is what the scriptures are meant to do in my life, in your life, to not just inform us of the truth, but transform us into people who embody the truth. So we are, to use the words of Henry Nouwen, to be read by scripture, not just readers of it. He says it this way: reading in a spiritual way is reading with a desire to let God come closer to us. The purpose of spiritual reading is not to master knowledge or information, but to let God's Spirit master us. Strange as it may sound, spiritual reading means to let ourselves be read by God. And so we are to engage in reading the scriptures regularly, but we are also to allow God to come near us through the scriptures, so near that we begin to see the story scripture tells as the truest story about reality. And we're going to practice that in the next few sessions. And today, let's end asking God to allow us to have the heart posture to let scripture tell us the truest story about reality. Let's pray. Lord, we thank you for the gift of your word, and we thank you for the gift of your scriptures. God, speak to us through it, inform us about who we are, and transform us into people who embody that new creation identity you give us. God, be with us in these next sessions as we pick up the skill of reading your scripture well and drawing close to you through it. We ask that in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you again for being with us, and join us the next couple sessions as we put this to practice.